Hello everyone. This video demonstrates another versatile tool, the Live Paint Bucket tool, that creates an interactive painting experience, allowing you to apply color to areas without the need to create separate shapes or parts. So let's learn how to use it. At the moment, my fill color is white and stroke is black. So let's first change the fill to no fill. And then let's pick the ellipse tool. Holding Shift and Option on a Mac or Shift and Alt on a PC, I'm going to click and drag to draw a circle. I think the stroke weight needs to improve a little, so let's change it to 2 points. Now, holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, I'm going to make another copy of the circle and place it as illustrated. So basically, I don't want the two circles in my design. I just want this overlapped area and get rid of the rest. So let's select them all and pick the Shape Builder tool. Now, holding Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, let's click and drag to remove the unwanted portions. Now we're left with this petal, and I'm going to duplicate this several times using the Rotate tool. To bring the Rotate tool, you can also use the shortcut R. Now to bring the setting, just double-click the Rotate tool, and it shall bring you this pop-up window. You can find that the shape has already moved according to the angle pre-selected here. So let the angle be 18 degrees, and instead of hitting OK, hit the copy button, and the pop-up window shall be gone. Now the interesting part. Hold Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and keep hitting the letter D, D for duplicate, to complete the circle. You've got yourself a nice and even flower already. Let's select the shape and drag to increase the size of our flower. With the flower selected, let's now pick the Live Paint Bucket tool, and you shall find it second in the stack of the Shape Builder tool. You can even use the shortcut K to bring it. So when the Live Paint Bucket tool is selected, you can find a tiny color palette getting friendly with the cursor. This is the same color palette that you find in the Color Swatches panel. When you click the right arrow key, you'll find the color switching in the same sequence as in the Color Swatches. And the same will happen using the left arrow key. It's just that the selected color will move backward instead of forward. Also, be aware that out of the three tiny color windows, the one in the middle is the active one. So, with the red one active, I'm going to take the cursor to the outermost petal and click to color the whole outer area red. And this is what makes the Live Paint Bucket so versatile, because it's really useful for quickly adding color to complex illustrations or designs. Now let's say for the next color, I don't want to select from the color swatches, but pick a shade myself from the color palette. So when I take my cursor to the color palette, the cursor turns itself into an eyedropper tool. And at this time, you can still see the tiny color palette at 3 waiting outside like an obedient friend. But the moment I make my selection, the mini palette divorces itself from the cursor. So let's fill in the next row with the selected color. Now, the moment I make the selection for the next color from the color swatches, the mini palette is going to reclaim its friendship with the cursor. Let's fill the next row with this color now. So you see, filling different closed shapes works like a charm with the Live Paint Bucket tool. Now here, I made a mistake and filled in a slot from a different row. To fix this, all you need to do is hold Option on a Mac or Alt on a PC, at which point the cursor will turn into an eyedropper tool. Pick the right color by clicking the color once, and then paint the slot with the right color. Another thing you can do with the Live Paint bucket is you can draw additional closed or open path objects, and then merge these objects into an existing Live Paint group. To demonstrate this, let's pick the Line Segment tool, and then draw a vertical line in the center and over the design. Similarly, draw a horizontal line on the design, as illustrated. Now select all the elements on the screen and pick the Live Paint Bucket tool. And when you take the cursor close to the newly formed area and click to paint, you'll find this error asking you to click the merge button. You'll find the merge button sitting comfortably on top of the screen, so click it once. Now when you roll over the cursor to the new areas that were created where existing lines intersect with lines in the merged object, this highlights them. Simply use the right or left arrow to select the color of your choice from the swatches and click to apply the color fill. You can also use the Live Paint Bucket tool to apply separate stroke colors to each edge of a Live Paint group. Yes, you heard that right. The Live Paint Bucket not just helps you paint the fillable areas, but also the strokes. To activate that, double-click the Live Paint Bucket icon, which will reveal this pop-up menu. All you need to do here is to check the Paint Strokes option and hit OK. Select the stroke square and click the swatch color you want to apply to place it in the middle color preview for the tool. Next, position the Live Paint Bucket tool over an edge segment. The pointer will change from a bucket icon to a brush icon, and the highlight width will become thinner. Click an edge to change its color. You can even change the stroke weight using this option, so let's change the stroke weight to 4 points. Now when I click the stroke, it will not just update the color of the stroke, but also the stroke weight. Lastly, there is one tool which sits in the same stack, and it's this one. It's the Live Paint Selection tool. The shortcut to enable it is Shift-L. What it does is it removes the fill or strokes. So let's say I don't want this line to divide this petal. So I'm going to click it to select it and hit the backspace or delete key, and the stroke is gone. Let's do that with the other ones as well. So the area or stroke when highlighted, just click it depending on what you want to remove, and then just hit the delete key and you will get rid of the element. So guys, that's all about the Live Paint Bucket tool. In the next video, we'll learn to use another powerful tool of Illustrator, and that's the pen tool, so ensure not to miss the next one. I hope you've liked the video, and if you did, do hit the like button, and please share the video and subscribe to my channel, and I shall be with you soon with the next one. Goodbye, and thanks for watching.